Captain's log, stardate 6147.4. We're orbiting planet Taurus 2 and the Murasaki 312 nebula. Our orders: investigate the disappearance of a science vessel in this area. Search and rescue operations are about to commence.
People you can interact with have icons above their heads. Press the X button to talk with them.
Lieutenant, we've located the wreckage of a crashed ship down there. I need to get boots on the ground. Find out what's going on. Take a land not so fast. We can't use the transporters due to atmospheric interference. We'll need to take a shuttlecraft down. Use the sensors to locate a safe landing site. Did you find a suitable landing area? Excellent. I've assigned Ensign Mears to your landing party. She's been to Taurus 2 before. Her insight will be quite valuable. Meet up with her and the others in the shuttle bay. Don't forget to grab a phaser in the armory on your way. From what I've read in Jim Kirk's report, Taurus 2 can get a little rough.
Ensign Tarsi, reporting for duty. The captain's asked me to make sure you get back in one piece, and I intend to do just that. Let's see. M-class planet? Barely. The Taurians are big, primitive, and quick to anger. I'd keep my phaser handy if I were you. Speaking of which, if you want to follow me to the armory, we can make sure your phaser is properly calibrated.
Your mini-map shows you where your objectives are. An arrow will appear on the mini-map if you are far away from your objective.
Good job, Lieutenant. That should be enough, unless you want more practice.
Ensign Mears, reporting as ordered. I'm ready when you are. Though I can't say I'm happy to see Taurus 2 again. I was one of the so-called Galileo 7, a science team sent to study the Murasaki effect. Our shuttle crashed on Taurus 2. Not all of us made it back to the Enterprise alive. Thank you. You can see why I'm reluctant to return to such a place. Yes, of course you're right, Lieutenant. I am a Starfleet officer, and I will perform my duties. You can count on me.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Just as grim as I remember it here. My skin is crawling. I can't help but feel like the creatures are out there, watching us, waiting to attack. Right. Okay. It appears the ship crashed somewhere north of here. There are two paths from here that lead to the crash site, and there may be survivors on both. I recommend you take Alpha Team along the northwestern path, and I'll take Beta to the northeast. We'll rendezvous at the main crash site.
Remember, your mini-map shows you where your objectives are. An arrow will appear on the mini-map if you are far away from your objective. To sprint, press and hold the left stick while moving.
Is that a warp nacelle? Whoa. Big.
Definitely Federation tech here. What's left of our shuttlecraft's coolant assembly, according to my tricorder. There's your crashed shuttle. What's left of it, anyway. Look, someone's over there. I think they're hurt. You won't be able to get close enough to revive him while that thing's venting plasma. Those valves should shut down the vents, though.
Thank you. We need to move. Those things, they're out there!
These things. Never mind.
A
I'm Dr. Phineas Grogan, part of a research team studying the Murasaki effect. Well, I was before the ship crashed. I was looking for supplies when that thing roared. Got distracted and then that plasma coil blew. Damn near killed me. You're telling me? We should get those supplies back to camp. Dr. Mueller's probably worried sick about it by now.
Am I glad to see you? We thought we were stranded here with those monsters. Those supplies you brought will come in handy while we wait. Just put them over there for now. You know, I think there's some old phaser rifles in there. Might come in handy against those creatures.
There are rifles in that crate. We should show the survivors how to shoot them. I'll set up some targets while you get ready.
A phaser? I've never shot one of these before.
Wait,
you
want me to shoot this?
To do so, press the options button and select the captain option under the ship and crew heading.
The targets are ready, Lieutenant. Let the survivors start shooting and give them some pointers.
I get it. That gives me a lot more control.
Wow, thanks. That feels a lot better.
They're right behind me!
Heads up! The Taurians are attacking!
We need to get these people to safety, Lieutenant. The Taurians will be back, and in greater numbers.
Into the ship? But then we'll be trapped.
Retreat to the ship? With pleasure!
Shut the doors! They're right behind us! Okay. Last time I was here, Commander Scott, electrified the hull of our shuttle. That drove the Taurians off when they tried to break in. Think we can pull something like that off here?
Oh.
You did it! Lieutenant, it worked! Bless you, Scotty, wherever you are. I think we owe you a very nice bottle of scotch. The Taurians ambushed us. I managed to escape, but the others... they've been taken. We've got to do something, and fast!
I was thinking... we can use our tricorders to track residual heat signatures left by the Taurians.
Thanks for coming back for us, sir. We owe you one. Pretty sure those things were gonna have us for dinner.
Fascinating. The Taurians appear to be in a late Stone Age state of development.
Now isn't the best time for an anthropology lecture, Skial.
Am I seeing things? Because those guys picking through the wreckage sure look like Klingons. Just what are the Klingons doing on Taurus 2? Looks like they're not in the mood for questions, Lieutenant. Klingon pad? Bring it to me. I have some experience decrypting Klingon data. Huh. My little sister's diary was harder to decrypt. Sure, Klingons are good at fighting, but computers aren't exactly their strong suit. And voila! One Klingon pad unlocked and ready for your inspection.
Captain Kor, your plan is working. Perfectly, sir. Many ships have fallen into our trap. We've snared a few merchant ships and a Starfleet science vessel so far. You'll be pleased to hear that we're picking up a Federation cruiser on long-range sensors. Constitution class. Time to hunt bigger game. Glory to the Empire!
Looks like the Klingons are using both guile and brute force here, Lieutenant. A pretty potent combination. The captain's definitely gonna want to hear about this. To the shuttle before more of them show up.
We're ready to go when you are. Hope this thing's got enough fuel to get us back to the ship. Are you ready to board the shuttle, Lieutenant?
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Never thought I'd be so happy to see a shuttle bay. I admit I had my doubts in the beginning. Didn't think I'd hold it together down there. Every time I heard those things roar. But here I am. Thanks for believing in me.
We have some uninvited guests, Lieutenant. We've been boarded. The Klingons have breached the hull on the engineering deck and blocked our access. Start with the engineering lab.
I'm remembering an old Earth adage about leaping from frying pans into fires. Your orders, Lieutenant?
We'll handle these Klingons. Sounds like you're needed in the engineering lab.
I'll cover you while you clear out the lab, Lieutenant!
Down our primary plasma conduits. Get them running, fast! Plasma conduits reinitialized. Auxiliary power restored. Now clear out that armory.
Watch out! More Klingons!
Great work. Secure engineering next if you can.
We've cleared the rest of the deck, Lieutenant.
Nice work. Internal sensors show you secure the engineering deck. I need you to take a look at the engines now. The Klingons fouled them up good.
Some missions in Star Trek Online will change based on your career track. Engineering, science, or tactical.
Back online. Initiate evasive maneuvers. I need you on the bridge, Lieutenant.
Sir, incoming transmission.
Federation Starship, this is Captain Kor.
Surrender if you must, but I'd rather you fight with honor.
Good work, Lieutenant. The Klingons will think twice before they try to board this ship again. Now take the helm. We need to get to a friendly sector.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Sensors are picking up Klingon power signatures in two nearby satellites. I'm thinking they're broadcasting the distress signals that lured in our ships. Bring us in close so we can scan them and find out.
Press up to increase your ship's speed. Press down to decrease your ship's speed.
Science report coming in now. The satellites are using a triaxillating signal. It's strong enough to cut through the interference and reach ships outside the nebula. Clever. Almost a shame we have to blow them up, isn't it?
Position yourself near the beacon and press the X button to interact with it.
Use your torpedo to attack enemies who are not shielded.
Warning, ship is under attack.
Nice work. One down, one to go. Looks like this one is shielded.
You must be within 10 kilometers of an enemy to attack it. Use your phaser beam to weaken shielded targets.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
Use your torpedo on an enemy when their shield is down. You must be out of combat to answer the hail. The red alert message at the top of your screen will indicate if you are in combat.
Can you hear us? We're under attack by Klingon raiders. Our shields are buckling. Won't last long.
Hold the up button to activate and deactivate full impulse.
Warning.
Thanks for the help. Our engines are offline. Could you transfer some energy and get them started again? Thanks for everything. Good luck with the Klingons.
Lieutenant, I've made some modifications to our torpedo launcher. I think you'll like the results.
Hold the up button to activate and deactivate full impulse. Press the circle button to activate high gear torpedo.
Your head will decorate my bridge!
More Klingon ships detected on long-range sensors, sir.
Lay in an intercept course, block weapons, and fire at will.
So, the cub comes to fight beside the wolfie, and now you will die with him as well. Myself upon you and your lackey.
Thank you for your assistance. Congratulations.
Looks like we're done here, people. Starfleet Command wants us and Enterprise back for a debriefing on this mess. Helm, set a course for Earth Space Dock, Warp Factor 3.
Captain Garrett wants to see you in his office, Lieutenant. But he says to feel free to mingle with the other officers first. I'd take him up on that if I were you. I mean, how often do you get the chance to meet the crew of the Enterprise? The best of the best.
Lieutenant Uhura of the Starship Enterprise.
We were in Starfleet Academy together.
Great bird of the galaxy, bless your planet.
That was some fine work back there, friend. It's not every day one walks away from a brawl with the Klingons. You look familiar. If you don't mind me saying so, have we met before? Ah, must be my imagination, then. You meet a lot of folks serving in Starfleet, to be sure. By the way, I heard you ran into the local wildlife on Taurus too. Right unfriendly devils, aren't they? I won't be forgetting those gigantic spears anytime soon. Look me up sometime. We'll have a drink and share some caveman tales.
If you're going into the lion's den, you'll need a medical officer.
It's been a pleasure working with you. I didn't enjoy going back to Taurus too, but we got the job done thanks to you. Starfleet First Officers must be my good luck charm. Captain Garrett has requested me for a new logistics position here at ESD. Might not be as glamorous as the Final Frontier, but I've accepted. Until next time, good luck out there.
Thanks for coming. I have some good news to share. First off, Fleet promoted me to Admiral. I'll be working with Deep Space Command on several exploration initiatives there. Our ship's going to need a new captain. I've talked it over with Command. They agree with my recommendation. You. Congratulations, my friend. I know the ship will be in good hands once I'm away. Don't think you've gotten rid of me, though. I plan on keeping you plenty busy out there.
Congratulations, Lieutenant. Every generation, Starfleet officers hear the call of duty. Hidden dangers lurk in space, and the threat of Klingon attack has made even the most stout-hearted reconsider their choice to travel throughout the stars. A last-ditch effort to find a common ground could end this conflict. But there are many who oppose peace. If the Federation is to be saved from chaos, new officers will need to take up the task of restoring peace. Live long and prosper, Lieutenant. Congratulations, Lieutenant.
I have some new orders for you. I've outlined important people you should talk to while visiting Earth's space dock. Speak with the tailor to customize your appearance. After that, speak with the ship vendor to claim a shuttlecraft. Stay safe out there. You have your orders. Hello. Hello. I don't have...
Your mini-map shows you where your objectives are. An arrow will appear on the mini-map if you are far away from your objective.
Thank you. Garrett said you would come by to requisition a new shuttle. While you're here, feel free to look. I'm here to help you choose a vessel. What would you like to know? Which one were you interested in?
Select the item.
I'm here to help you choose a vessel. What would you like? I'm here to help you. Which one were you interested?
I know that being a starship captain is a big responsibility. Stay safe out there. Ever hear of Edrin 4? Jim Kirk got into a tussle with a Gorn there. Barely lived to tell the tale. Stay safe out there.
Welcome to the Sol System.
Hold the X button.
All visitors to Earth Space Dock are required to fly close enough to the station for our tractor beams to lock onto your ship. Our automated systems will notify you when you are in position. This is Earth Space Dock. You can dock whenever you are ready. Welcome to the Sol System. All visitors to Earth Space Dock are required to fly close enough to the station for our tractor beams to lock onto your ship. Our automated systems will notify you when you are in position. This is Earth Space Talk. You're cleared to warp to Sector Space.
Hold A to bring up your Captain Commands menu, select Primary Mission, and then select Travel to automatically
fly to your destination. You are now in Sector Space. Sector Space is the main overworld map of Star Trek Online. From here, you can travel to different planets and systems. Sector Space is a no-combat zone.
We're reading several Gorn ships on our sensors, as well as the USS Zhangha. The Zhangha is hailing us now.
Welcome to Edron 4. I'm Bridget McKinnon, CO of the USS Zhangha. Glad you could join us. My science teams are on site and conducting initial surveys. Apparently, this place is quite the geological marvel. We're not the only ones present, though. Our friends from the Gorn hegemony aren't terribly chatty, but so far they're keeping the peace. Well, I'm sure my people wouldn't mind an extra hand down there on the geological marvel. Feel free to join the party.
Captain, the Gorn are scanning us. I recommend caution when dealing with the Gorn. They can be easily provoked.
We have entered the orbit of Edron 4,
Transporter room to bridge. The geological team, supplies, and gear are ready to beam down to Edron 4.
Lowering shields for transport.
I'm detecting some unusual energy signatures in orbital space near Edron 4. Recommend we perform a deep scan of each. They could be hazardous. Strange. For a moment there, it's nothing, Captain. Thought I was picking up an impulse drive. False alarm. I'll recalibrate the... Captain, the science and engineering teams indicate that they have made it to the surface and made contact with the science team from the Zhangha. The rest of the...
There you are. Better late than never, huh? Ensign Scavrin, Starfleet Corps of Engineers. Lovely planet we've got here. Charming, even, if you're fond of heat and rocks. Still, it's not a complete wash. To say this place is mineral-rich would be an understatement. My first assignment out of the Academy was on Vulcan, working at a geothermal power site in Shikar. Great people, the Vulcans. Good at arguments. Though all the logic comes off a little dry for my tastes.
Press left to scan the area. Your tricorder will point you toward your nearest objective.
My tricorder's showing some interesting mineral formations beyond this ridge.
This looks like a good place to start our scans.
Nice to see a report was spot on for once. The mineral deposits here are remarkably pure. This carbon deposit is unusually pure. Apparently, the Metrons don't prepare half-rate planets. Whoever gets the mineral rights to this planet will be pleased. Very pleased indeed. My readings indicate there might be dilithium on this planet. I'll need to take more scans to be sure. The variety of minerals in the topsoil alone is astounding. The soil here has a high concentration of sulfur. Either my tricorder is broken, or the soil here has an amazingly high concentration of sulfur. Have closed off the pass. We can't reach the camp. Who would do this?
Look, over there.
It's the Gorn.
This is Lieutenant Newman. One of the Gorn ships just exploded. They're blaming us and attacking our forces, on the surface and in orbit. Captain McKinnon tried to explain, but they aren't responding to any hails. Way ahead of you, Captain. We're defending ourselves, and our shields are up, which means we can't beam you back to the ship. Afraid you're on your own for now.
Over there. There might be a way out of this infernal canyon further down the valley. We need a way out of this canyon, and I'm thinking that big rock up there is it. With a little Federation ingenuity, we can topple this rock with a makeshift bomb. Once it's down, we can walk across it and get back to camp before the Gorn use the Zhonghas science team as target practice. Have you read Captain Kirk's report on this place?
Behind us!
Good. Let's take these materials over to the bottom of that huge rock. Right. Ensign Hunter. Well, at least the Gorn are punctual. Keep them off us! Crush that coal up good, Hunter. Not like that. Finer. Careful with that. Potassium nitrate can react explosively with these materials. Now mix it with the coal. Carefully. I'd rather not get blown to pieces today, if you don't mind. We're just about done. Bombs in place. Well, now that ends.
The bombs are primed to blow. We should move to a safe distance.
In the academy, they said that in the battle of man versus nature, man loses. Well, take that, nature. Absolutely. We should be able to climb that rock just fine. It's steep, but...
I hope the scientists are all right. The Gorn aren't known for their mercy. Looks like some Gorn came through here. We better hurry.
Thank you. Things were looking pretty grim there for a moment.
The Gorn. They kept saying the deaths of their people would be avenged, but we didn't do anything. I haven't fired a phaser since the Academy.
Glad you're in one piece, Captain. It's clear up here for the moment. Transporters are standing by. Glad you're in one piece, Captain.
Looks like the Gorn have exercised the better part of valor, Captain.
Good to hear from you. Thank you for saving my people. We're making repairs, but it'll be some time before our engines are back online. Picking up Gorn warp.
Ship under attack.
Press the right trigger to fire energy weapons. Press the right button to fire torpedoes. Thanks for covering us. The Gorn would have made short work of my ship otherwise. I owe you one. Slow, but steady. Our warp drive is still disabled, but we're making progress. thanks. I hate to ask, but something's bothering me. We picked up strange energy readings. Sending it now.
Of the Shangha were onto something. I ran a deep scan analysis of the Gorn debris, and the results are damn peculiar. Gorn ships aren't as tough as a Tellarite design, but our scaly friends know a thing or two about hull plating. Whoever fired this shot knew exactly where to hit them. Not with the data we have now, but the science team just found another strange energy reading nearby. From the Gorn ship, and some trace elements of weapons-grade plasma. Sir, I know who did this. It's the Romulans. I'll shave my eyebrows if I'm wrong. It's the Romulans, I'm sure of it. There's more bad news. The Gorn are coming back, weapon...
It's the same ship as before. Doesn't look like they're back at full strength, though.
Unprovoked act of aggression against our research vessel tells me otherwise. I see no Romulans, only Federation ships. Do you think me a fool, Captain? Most convenient, Captain. But I am unconvinced. Produce...
Captain, I've got an idea. If we can generate...
Quite the clever one, Captain. Too clever, I'm afraid. No one can know of our actions here.
Yeah.
fought Federation. The hegemony will remember the Romulan treachery today, and your assistance in exposing it. I propose we continue our joint surveys of Edryn IV under a mutual non-aggression pact.
So there was another player on the field. Nice work out there, Captain. We'll be heading for the closest starbase soon, but we'll be back to finish our work here, along with the Gorn, I'll wager. I think the Romulans will take a pass, though.
All decks have reported in. We're ready to disembark on your order.
Most missions can be turned in remotely. Hold the X button to bring up your Captain Commands menu and select
Turn. Good to hear from you. I've read Captain McKinnon. Stay safe.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Starfleet hasn't heard from Deep Space Station K-13 in a... Stay safe out there.
You are now in sector space. Here ships travel at warp speed between systems. Combat
keep me
does
apprised.
Not take place
Hello.
In sector space.
I don't...
We've arrived near Deep Space Kather. Sensors aren't detecting enemy vessels or... Captain, the other ships are raising shields and charging weapons. Ships disabled, Captain. Captain, those were the Starfleet ships assigned to patrol this sector. I don't think that was a war game or training sim. Their weapons were at full power.
Stay away! They're taking control! Don't come near us! They'll take you too! The station came from the station.
Message from Starfleet Command, Captain. We're to investigate the situation immediately. No signs of combat on board. Sensors are picking up a number of life signs over there. I don't like this. No one's at...
Skills will increase your effectiveness in both space and ground combat. Select any skill to see a full description of the benefits gained by purchasing it. Skills will increase your effectiveness in both space and ground combat. Select any skill to see a full description of the benefits gained by purchasing it. Every skill costs 1 point of the same type to purchase. You will earn 1 space point every 1 level and 1 ground point every 5 levels until you reach level 50. For each skill purchased, you will earn progress in unlock paths. Every skill costs 1 point of the same type to purchase. You will earn 1 space point every 1 level and 1 ground point every 5 levels until you reach level 50. For each skill purchased, you will earn progress in unlock paths.
Blast points on...
The lights have all been dimmed, but it looked...
Someone was expecting a fight. Against whom or what, I have no idea. Captain, I think I saw motion in that room to the left.
Stop where you are and turn about slowly. I need to determine if you are infected. Neural parasites. A life form last encountered by the crew of the Enterprise at Deneva Colony. Those possessed by the creatures tend to engage in hostilities with the uninfected, the better to render them fit for infestation. Temet, and while you have not engaged in hostilities thus far, I have seen infected employ false passivity. Scans show a slightly elevated level of adrenaline, though nowhere near that of an infected. According to Starfleet data files, the parasites can be safely destroyed by exposure to high-intensity ultraviolet light. My attempts at reconfiguring the station's lighting thus far have been unsuccessful. I am a physician, not a habitat engineer. As a precaution, I have developed a serum that can render a person toxic to the creatures. However, medical supplies here are limited.
Now there's a voice I wasn't expecting. I take it you heard my distress call then. Well, in case you haven't noticed, the station's been overrun by neuroparasites. The weed devils are back with a vengeance. I'm afraid not. I'm in the auxiliary control room, down on the engineering deck. The place is filthy with parasites, so you'll understand if I don't go out for a wee jaunt.
I have secured a small amount of security.
Equip your bridge officers by selecting them, then double-click an item in your inventory to have them equip it.
If we pass through the mess hall, we can access a turbo lift to reach engineering. Whenever you are ready.
Every skill costs 1 point of the same type to purchase. You will earn 1 space point every 1 level and 1 ground point every 5 levels until you reach level 50. For each skill purchased, you will earn progress in unlock paths.
these crew members. They're all infected by the parasites. Be careful.
Creatures continue to be resistant to tricorder scans, sir. It... The auxiliary control. Someone must have raised the security field to cut off the auxiliary engineering section from the rest of this deck.
Hi there. It's good to see a friendly face. There you are. I was beginning to get a bit concerned. Thought you might have been taken by those little beasties. I'll just lock the door so none of them can get in while we discuss our next course of action. Now that you're here, we've some work to do. The way I see it, we need to get to main engineering and turn on the station's ultraviolet lighting. That'll sort the nasty bugs out properly.
While I cannot attest to the ability of UV light to sort Denovan parasites, it will initiate a complete molecular breakdown within all parasites exposed to it.
Aye, she's a Vulcan, all right. I was trying to override the lighting controls from here. It looks like someone sabotaged several duotronic relays. We have to repair them if we're going to have any chance of saving the station. Before we go, grab yourself a kit from the crate there. It might come in handy. We'd better get a move on. The parasites aren't ones to loiter about.
Equip a kit to gain new ground combat abilities.
Aye, this is one of the broken relays, right here. That one was easy. Just a few more to go. All right, there are several ways through the engineering section here. Remember, the parasites like the dark. We devils that they are.
odds of success are greatest if we remain in well-lit areas.
Now this may be a bit tricky. Just a wee bit longer. There we are now. This one just needs new fuses. There we are, good as new. I'll have this fixed up straight away. That takes care of that. No trouble at all.
Thank you.
Yeah, it looks like someone has overridden the command codes. You best get to the command center and see what you can do from there. I'll stay here, barricade the door, and keep trying to get those UV lights going.
Look! Who are those soldiers? They're definitely not Starfleet.
Get the lights while the commander's down.
They're dying. All of them.
Salvage what you can and send a squad to kill the Federation vermin.
We need to talk. Actually, the name's Daniels. This may be a little difficult to absorb, but recent events may make it more plausible. I'm actually from the future. I can't tell you how far. Just that it's a future worth protecting. That's why I'm here now. The aliens we're fighting are called the Nakul, and they're waging a temporal cold war with us. They're trying to change the timeline here in order to disrupt the future. Understand that I follow a temporal version of the Prime Directive. There's only so much I can reveal to you. Trust that we're doing the right thing here. I can't tell you how far, just that it's a future worth protecting. Time's a factor. We need to stop the Nakul from obtaining the neural parasites. The Nakul ship that brought these invaders is now fighting the USS Ptolemy.
We can return to the ship on your orders. The Ptolemy is holding the Nakul off while we rescue the other ships, but they won't last long.
I'm transferring command codes to you now. Use them to remotely access the computer on those disabled ships and emit an ultraviolet flash inside.
This is Captain Serralt of the Ptolemy. We have engaged the enemy ship, but we are outmatched. Please restore those ships and join the fight quickly.
That did it, Captain. Looks like everyone's coming around. The parasites are gone.
This is Captain Doherty of the USS Myrmidon. What happened? What's going on? Parasites? What?
Fine work, Captain. You sent those devils back to wherever they came from. We do have a wee problem, however. The burst I sent, when combined with the power source, created a feedback pulse. Scott here. The portal's collapsing. We're in for a right bumpy ride.
Everyone's aboard. Get us clear before that portal blows. There she goes. I don't think anyone's ever seen a station do that.
Captain, before K-13 was pulled into the vortex, I picked up a few distress signals. From inside the station.
Perhaps not. After all, it was a temporal vortex. They may well survive. In another time. Well then, it's been quite a day, hasn't it? Neural parasites. Time-traveling raiders. Why, things will seem almost normal once I'm back on the Enterprise. Speaking of, I'm sure the ships here can give me a lift back to her now that they're parasite-free. If Starfleet Command gives you any grief on this, remind them that lives are more valuable than equipment. And you saved a lot of lives today.
I apologize for springing all of this on you at the last minute, and I'll explain more as soon as I can. For now, I can tell you that history is unfolding as it should, and that was not the end of K-13.
Your system scans clear, Captain. Looks like everything's getting back to normal. We can leave the system on your orders.
Let me get this straight. K-13, an entire space station, just disappeared into some type of spatial anomaly? And I thought some of Kirk's after-action reports were a little out there. Starfleet Command won't be pleased with the loss of K-13, or the people that were still on board. But they'll be happy to hear about the lives you did save. Good work out there. Keep it up.
Stay safe. Congratulations, Lieutenant.
You have a new captain power available in your radio menu. Press the L2 button to show all your powers. Use the left stick to navigate this radio menu. Press the L3 button to set your quick power and update the default captain power to use. Press the right trigger to activate a power directly from this radio menu.